1962 Shasta here that just came back from the paint shop. Bob and Cindy have been working on it for some people. And it's ready for the tile floor. And I'm going to put the tile floor in for them. So I want to make you aware of a buddy of mine in Kentucky, and on YouTube he's known as Redneck Responder. His name's Scott, and for the last 30 years he's been in the floor business. Knows everything there is to know about tile. So I asked Scott to, if he would shoot a video for me and show me how to do this stuff right. You saw me do it in the DeVille and it came out pretty good, but one of the things that I didn't know about was that you're supposed to put the glue down first and let it dry and then you put the tile down. I put it down on the wet glue and for weeks we were cleaning up glue that was squeezing up through the cracks. And I also didn't know how to cut it properly. So we're going to learn all these things now through Scott's efforts. What I would like you to do before you watch my videos, go ahead and turn me off and go down to Scott's link that I have down here and watch his videos first. I think there's two of them. Whatever, I'll put the links down here. Go watch his videos and then come back and watch my videos because I want you to see from his point of view how it's done and his basics, and then come back here and watch my videos and I'll show you how we apply his knowledge and his basics to our trailers. So with that, go ahead and turn me off right now and go to Scott's channel down below here and then come back and see me. Now this is the finished product, of course, and I'm going to show you how we got here. But the first thing I'm going to show you, we're going to skip floor prep because I've covered all that in my other videos. So we're going to assume that your floor is ready for this, and that means clean, sanded, all the debris taken off, any divots filled in, whatever, new floor, whatever you did. So it's just plywood when you start. And the first thing that you have to do is a layout to figure out how you want to run your tiles and where you want to make your cuts. But this is the final product when we get done. So with that, let's go ahead and get to laying out our tile and then getting the glue down. All right, one thing I did want to show you, we have a 22-inch door here. So what I like to do is I like to center the tiles in the doorway for my beginning, you know, to start everything. That way when you're entering, it's, you know, it's easy on the eyes because everything's centered and not offset. So this line going this way is going to center in this door. That's 11 inches from side to side, half of 22. So, and what we've done is we've laid out our tiles in a straight line along this cabinet and then centering on the door. And I've made a line here all along. You can see my line sticking out over here. I've made a line all along here with pencil all the way down to here. See the line? Okay. They're under there. If you look, see? There's a line. And this is my layout. Now there's going to be a lot of cuts in this trailer because all the cabinets weren't pulled out. At any rate, what we've done here, the main thing you want to make sure of is that you go over your seams. See, this is a seam here. You want to make sure that you are spanning over the seam. You don't want to end up with a seam of the tile on the seam of the plywood, because then you're going to have the tile coming up later on. So, but I'm spanning the seam, as you see. The seam is here. The tile spans over it. All right, so this is our layout. This is where we'll get started. Now I'm just going to put all the glue down. I'm going to take the tile out, clean this out real good, and then I'm going to put the glue down and let it set overnight. You want to start with what kind of trowel do you need? Well, you need a 1/16 inch notch trowel. 1/16 inch, okay? Nothing bigger. That's all you want. All right, and you can reuse these trowels if you clean them up. So you also want to have a nice new can of WD-40. Okay, WD-40, believe it or not, works on cleaning this stuff up. So have that around and have a good solid roll of paper towels. Now you want to keep this stuff within reach when you're working. And I'm filming this inside of a trailer, so I don't have a lot of room. And also, like I said, you can go to my DeVille video when I did the floor there and take a look at that. Pardon me for having all these crappy clothes on, but I don't like to wear good clothes when I'm going to be doing this kind of sticky, gooey stuff. So I've got all my old crappy clothes on. So anyway, okay, here we go. It's got to be 85 degrees right now, nice and comfortable. And then there's bugs over here. One of the reasons I don't really like working over here. I prefer to work at my place, but when I have to, I'll come over here. I showed you earlier that we made lines on the floor. Those will actually show through. This stuff is yellow to begin with, but it dries clear. And what we're going to be doing is putting all the glue down today, and then we're going to let it dry overnight. Yep, that's what I said. We're going to let it dry overnight. That's how you do this. If you put the glue down and then put the tiles on it wet, it'll take weeks to dry, and you'll constantly be cleaning up the glue that squeezes up through the cracks, through the seams. So what you really do is you lay it down and get it as clean as you possibly can, and then you let it dry overnight, and then you come in and you'll be able to see the lines through the tile, through the glue that you made, and you'll be able to lay down your tile. So this part here sometimes takes a little getting used to handling this stuff. You know, you're not in a hurry, you don't have to beat it or anything like that, you know, as far as you're not worried about drying time or anything like that. So just take your time and don't make a mess. You know, if you can do that, just put the stuff down. I know you can't see me right now because I'm in a corner, but I will go ahead and shut the video down, and when I get out here where you can see me, I'll start it back up again. Okay, I'm going to hope you can kind of see over my shoulder. I won't know until I look at the video. But basically, this stuff's pretty liquidy, so you just kind of slap it on there, you know, and use circular motion like that. You don't want any big high ridges or anything like that. So you can use it sparingly, but make sure you get full coverage. And again, you know, if you're the more lumpy your floor is, the harder it's going to be for the tile to stick properly. And some other words of caution, you want to go around and make sure that there's no staples or nails or anything sticking up out of the plywood or out of the sides of the cabinets, like I just found over here. There's a staple sticking out. So after the glue dries, I'll pull that staple, but I didn't see it before. So there's things like that in the prep work you want to run around and make sure that you take care of. Careful not to get it on cabinets, but if you do, you can get it off with WD-40. Okay, I kind of have to get out of my own way now, so we'll just continue doing this. We'll do this out to about here, and then we'll turn our attention over here and start in this corner and work back to there. And then out the door. You know, we'll come here and work our way out the door backwards. Don't want to work yourself into a corner. stop right about here so that I can move around without getting sticky and go over to that other corner. So you can see this doesn't really take very much time. Okay, we're going to do this corner. It's hard to get out of my own way here, especially with the camera in here. Okay. At this point, I'm going to have to drop the camera because there's no more room in here for both of us. So, just going to work my way out the door. It's all loose. All told, I think the gluing probably is going to take me, including setting up the camera and everything, I probably have a half hour in the glue. The layout, I spent probably an hour doing all that. And then tomorrow we'll go ahead and cut the tile and put it in. Okay, as you can see, I think you can see it anyway. It's already starting to dry. But glued my way out the front door, the only door. And we're going to go away now. Tomorrow morning I'll come back and lay the tile.